I'm telling you, today has been crazy. I just finished working out. That's weird. My phone is lagging. Must be the storm. Yeah, there's a storm coming. I can hear thunder. I'm so excited because I love a good downpour. Although I kept telling myself this morning that I need to do the laundry in the morning because I won't want to tonight. And then I kept thinking, I'll just do it tonight. Probably won't happen. But anyways, I'm feeling pretty good. I have been so extremely tired this last month, it feels like. And I feel determined to figure out why. Because my iron and my EPO is at a great level in my system. My dialysis is working beautifully. And so, really, the only thing I can kind of come up with is that my body is actually trying to do everything it's supposed to do instead of relying on perhaps the iron shots. I'm continually eating red meat. I'm eating really great vegetables. So I don't know, it's a little bit of a mystery and it's very discouraging, I would have to say, because I'm very used to being, well, you guys know, upbeat. And I don't know, somebody told me like maybe the heat had something to do with it because the heat does destroy me. I don't know. I don't know why I live here, but I do. And so today is a cloudy day. Yesterday was a pretty cloudy day. The morning was really nice, although I did not get my walk in. I just could not get out of bed. And then I forced myself out of bed because I needed to go to Costco, and I hate going to Costco, but I have been. So one of the advantages of having Ben is that he can carry my water for me up the steps. So we went to Costco and ended up getting, like the case of water. And I try not to buy the little bottle waters too much, but I'm gonna tell you that when I first moved in, I used to brew coffee in a little coffee pot, like a little Mr. Coffee. And it has, little Mr. Coffee has like a filter thing that sits on top of the water, right? So you pour your water into the filter drains down into your grounds, and then it will brew your coffee, like whatever. Well, about 2 weeks after moving in, I was like, what are all these little rocks? So I went to the office and I was like, hey, what is this stuff? And they're like, oh, we have really bad water. And I'm like, you guys know I have kidney disease. Like, I can't drink this water. Anyway, she's like, yeah, we have the worst water, but you can purchase water at our water filtering station outside the office. So that's what we do all the time. I do buy brand new water from like Fry's, but I try to reuse those bottles like for a good month or two, and then I'll like change out. But I just tell you that there are days where we're running low on water and I don't have the energy to go get the water in the heat. I would die a horrible death if I lived back in the pioneer days because I would not want to go get the water. So I like to get the Costco bottled waters just for backup. And there's sometimes where I grab a bottle or two at night, and I always have water by my bed stand, so I always want to make sure that I have water. And so in the back of my mind, to me, like I'm always constantly thinking, when is my dialysis exchange and what am I eating? But also, like, where's my water? It's kind of like a weird, I don't want to say like trauma. Maybe it's a weird trigger that starts to happen because you're like, water, where do I get water? And then there's so many times where I go someplace and I totally forget to take water. I'm so dumb, especially in Tucson, So I've learned to grab one of those water bottles, and I have like a recycled, let me show you, it's really kind of cute. Everything's falling. See my little water bottle? Yeah, I like this little sticker. I got this actually at Walmart about, I don't even know, maybe 2 years ago. Still going great. What I like about it is it has the straw that goes all the way down, of course, but you don't tilt it. So you don't have to do this thing while you're driving. You literally just drink it straight, and it doesn't hardly spill if it gets knocked over. So it's like my favorite water bottle. But the thing I didn't think about was it's so fat. So it doesn't fit into my cup holders very well. Although I do take it with me quite often. And then I got actually a Starbucks one from Carmi for Mother's Day. So I've been using that one for orange juice to kind of pump up my potassium a little bit, because that was the one thing that Beth said the other day that I needed to work on some more, is just my potassium intake. And I just have been preoccupied with everything else going on, like the painters. I'm just so glad they're gone. They're just down on the other building now. And from what I can tell, they have not finished that either. So I'm done with that, I think. But yeah, so anyways, went to Costco and then got a little bit to eat there and then came home and I was already so exhausted. So I did my exchange and then I laid down for about half an hour. And I find if I take a half an hour nap, maybe a 20-minute nap, I feel great. Sometimes if I take an hour nap, like I want to take an hour nap and I take an hour nap, then I'm like dragging the rest of the night. But I just went ahead and got up and then I went ahead and did a workout. And now I feel really good, although I do feel tired. But I did notice during the workout that I felt a little mushy. Like I wanted to stop, and I've never wanted to stop before because that's just not an option. But my body literally was like, I'm tired. And so it kicked into that like mind over matter thing. It really does come down to your body just does not want to do. But if you tell it to do, it will do. So keep doing. I guess that's my message today. Don't give up. I went ahead and set up my calendar. Look at my calendar for June. Like literally everything on here, there's like nothing I added because I didn't hardly do anything. It was so horrible. This is my true confessions. Okay, but next week, what is it? Next Friday is the 1st of July. And so I went ahead and set up my calendar. Hey, so yesterday I got interrupted because my daughter called about her baby shower. And so that was kind of like, ended up talking to her for like an hour and a half, which is great. But totally interrupted my flow. I don't really even remember what I was talking about yesterday. However, today I did work out, which is why I look gross. And then I'm going to take a shower. I'm doing my exchange right now. And I'm doing laundry, but not all of it because I'm so tired. But I did do a workout again today and it was really hard because I have a step now. I follow the Les Mills workout routines. They're a company out of New Zealand. And they do like aerobic steps. Like it's literally a step thing that you step on. But all this time I didn't have one. And mostly because they're just pretty costly. And it's not something I have to have. Well, I tried it today and it was so hard. There's just something so different about using a step versus just the floor. I have to be very careful though, because jumping is not pleasant and I don't want to shift and shake around my peritoneum that is filled with fluid. I don't want to be aggressive about that. So it was a little surprising because I did have to take it quite a bit slow, or there's areas where I just had to go on the ground and not use the step, which I'm used to doing it that way. And I have a downstairs neighbor, so I'm trying not to be obnoxious about the whole thing. So I did my best. I'm pretty sure I was pretty loud anyways, but that's just the way it is. You know, she has a kid that likes to scream at like 2 or 3 in the morning and bang things around, and it's fine. So other than that, that's about all for today, I guess. I do feel good after working out. There's something about doing the workout that's great, even though before the workout, I don't want to do it. I don't know. It's like I want to, but my body's like, I don't want to. My body's like, please go take a nap. So I'm going to do my exchange. It's about 1. And then after my exchange, then I'm going to take my nap because I have the gym to go to tonight and I have other things to get going. Like I need to put my bed back together. Whenever I wash the sheets, it seems like a task to put the bed back together. And then I have laundry to fold. I have dinner to cook. And I just want to sleep. So, But it's kind of cool because I've been hanging out with Ben today. His dad did not pick him up. So we're just hanging out. We watched The Mist, which is a movie in 2007 about a mist or like a fog. If you don't know what mist is, it's similar to fog. But in the movie, it has creatures in it. A group of people get caught in the supermarket and they can't leave because they don't know what's eating everybody, which are these alien type monsters. It's just pretty. It's fun to watch movies like that with Ben because to hear how he thinks is really how you learn about another individual. For the most part, my children are very realistic and very like proactive. We don't sit in the corner and cry about things. We actually figure out how to get through it. So I would be totally fine if The Mist happened because I'm pretty sure me and Ben could figure out a way to be productive and not to be seduced by super religious lady who was telling everybody how it was God's will to destroy them all because of their sin and destruction and like fire and brimstone kind of talk. It's funny to watch because it's like, yeah, that's not what Jesus is about. It's so easy for people to get in fear and then not be able to get out of that. So that's basically what the movie's about. But it's fun to watch it with Ben because we think of different things to do or to use or how we would behave if we were in that situation. And whether it's like The Mist or supernatural things, or I would say we're more like, what is it called? Like the end of the world, apocalyptic watchers, you know, we don't mind zombies. It's fun because he's 14, 15 almost, and to see how his mind thinks is really cool. We have a dinosaur loose in the house. Hey, Marshall. Whew, I just finished working out and he was outside. Now he's looking for his cool little spot to take his siesta. Marshall. 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 Hey, buddy. There he goes. He's like, I was outside. I like to keep him out for a while. Give him some sun and some regular temperature that a tortoise should be or should know about. There he goes. He probably thinks my step is his new little cubby. Ugh, I need to vacuum. Gosh. I'm going to take a shower and get ready for the day. He's like, what's this? Bops it with his head. There he goes. Off to explore.